In ridiculous request news, submitted by I'm with Steve F. Water. Nice.
You
my man.
That, Steve?
Oh, he's drinking water.
He almost grabbed the water bottle. He literally, he went like this. He was like,
whiskey and energy for me.
I thought you were doing better.
He is. He's lying. It's a front.
No, I'm surprised you don't drink Red Bull and vodka all day. Because those are the two things you enjoy,
I do enjoy Red Bull vodka. Well, I just did that in Vegas.
Your entire water bottle is filled with vodka, right? We just don't know.
Oh, that'd be tight.
Yeah. What exactly is Reign, too? I've seen it, but I don't really know what it is.
It's like a new.
It's like Monsters. It's Monsters Bang.
That's what's the difference between Bang and
Monsters? That's why Bang is suing Monster. It's because they copied their whole,
But what's the difference between Reign and Monster? Is it Monster?
No, this one's stronger, 300 milligrams.
So it's just a stronger monster.
Yeah, it's just stronger, and there's other vitamins.
Hey, Bart.
Yeah, it's like zero calorie kind of. Hey, it's got different flavors.
You want to race me?
I'm down to try.
100 milligrams of what?
No, you caffeine. Definitely don't want to.
Damn.
In that drink,
yeah.
Who do you think can consume more caffeine between the two of you? Because you guys.
Your pre-workout
you guys
or that?
Both consume
monster?
A lot of caffeine.
I don't know.
I think I do.
I mean, I'm not proud of it. I don't want to consume so much caffeine.
I'm very proud of it.
Yeah. You take your pre-workout every day?
No, just the days I lift.
All right, that's Monday, what I mean. Like every day that you lift.
Yeah. Monday, Wednesday, Fridays, I take pre-workout.
How much milligrams is that?
350.
So dang, yes, you beat him.
No, but yeah. Then I'll drink like a coffee later on. So I'll probably be like 400 to 500
for the day.
But then depending on how many he drinks, it could be 600, 700, 800.
Yeah, maybe when I was 6 years old.
Damn, Steve, you're so cool.
Right? It just gives you more energy.
It gives you that. Yeah.
Yeah, there's a ton of shit in there. So it just makes you like motivated as fuck to do. It's probably like the closest thing you're gonna get to legal meth.
Yeah, it's like or like legal cocaine.
Really?
Yeah, I think that's called Adderall.
Yeah,
but you don't need a prescription.
So you're just like,
it just makes you want to do anything.
Yeah, when I go to the gym, sometimes I just look around and I'm just like, nah.
You need to try some pre-workout. Try some pre-workout. Take a scoop.
No, but I don't want to be motivated.
Yeah, you don't take it.
At least you went to the gym. Pre-workout just can make me turn my car on faster, like, shh.
I'm home. Once you get to the gym.
I took it one time with Bart. And I was like, I don't ever want to take it again.
You just in the shower crying? How do you do this every day, bro?
It made me feel too invincible. And then I got really sore for 3 days from working out. And I was like, nah, we're not going home yet. I got to do more sets.
Wow.
But it was also during a time where he'd never worked out.
Yeah, that's true.
So it'd be different now. Because he was like, never worked out. And then the first time he was like, I'm going to also take pre-workout. And he went crazy.
Have you guys heard Mike Tyson talk about competition? How he can't do it anymore because he's like, I'm too hardcore, man.
Yeah.
It's one of my favorite fucking quotes.
Do you remember when Mike Tyson got mad at that I think it was a weigh-in at the fan? He was like, I'll freaking eat your children. I'll rip your heart out. We just like went on with our day. Like, Mike Tyson's crazy. Dude. Turn the channel. Anyway, Pete Davidson is demanding fans sign a $1 million NDA to attend his live shows.
Is that the SNL dude?
Yeah. That is the SNL dude. He used to be with Ariana Grande.
Yeah.
Grande, it's pronounced Grandy.
Grandy?
She actually said that one time.
It's not Grande?
It's Grandy. Right. She just lets us call her that. We're like, let's Starbucks.
Little girl. Well, it's just like Chrissy Teigen, it's Teigen.
Teigen, is it?
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
It's like how George Bush is war criminal.
You know what's crazy about that though? Like after all that stuff, after a couple years, he was like, he gave Michelle Obama a piece of candy. We're like, man, forget all that stuff, man.
He's good old Uncle Bush.
Cool. He's like painting now. We're like,
then he hung out with Ellen and then he came back.
George Bush did?
Yeah.
Yeah,
they're sitting together at a game.
Everyone was giving Ellen shit. We're just like, how could you be friends with
him? Yep. So anyway, Pete Davidson, fans are like, what the fuck, man? Really? We're gonna. So his NDAs are saying that there will be a $1 million. Payment. It require a payment of $1 million in breach of the agreement if there's any damages, and it will also be as well as legal costs. So this one fan posted on his Facebook said, I got an email today informing me that in order to see this show, I have to sign a non-disclosure agreement. In that NDA, the signer cannot give any interviews, opinions, or critiques about it in any form whatsoever.
Is there an orgy that goes down? Like, how secret is this?
including blogs, Twitter, Facebook, Instagram, or any other
social reviews.
Yeah, I just don't think he wants people
to talk. But you can't review it or you can't post the footage?
Anything.
You can't talk about it, not even opinions.
You can't even say, man, Pete Davidson killed tonight. He was so
he wants him, I don't think.
Pete did what? $1 million now.
Yeah. I think that's what he wants.
So that's what it's claiming. So then it says, it also authorizes them to confiscate, including seize and destroy the contents of any cell phones, cameras, or PDAs, and that any breach of the agreement will require payment of $1 million in damages as well as the legal costs.
You're gonna destroy a whole cell phone just because you recorded some shit? You could delete the footage.
Tweet, and then the SWAT team busting you. Boom, give me the phone now, Joe! What I just said, I liked it! And they just smash it.
I know.
And they just leave. And also, you owe us $1 million.
Damn.
Do you collect phones at your stand-up sets now?
No.
A lot of stand-up comedians, I don't know how they do it, but they're collecting phones.
I don't have the money or resources to do it.
How do they do it?
I just feel like most people don't have that many followers.
Do they have like an offering plate that they pass around and people put the fucking...
No, they give you like a... They have like a Ziploc bag with like a zip tie on it. And then you have to put your phone, but I got two phones.
Yes.
If Pete Davidson's SWAT team shows up at my house for my cell phone, I'm running in the bathroom and I'm dumping all the pictures in the toilet.
Oh, in the toilet.
You're airdropping pictures to the toilet?
But I have a smart toilet.
Sin!
I have a smart toilet for that reason.
They hear it flushing, they're like, hey, stop it!
No, hey, you stop doing it! Take the door down! Take it off the tissues!
Somebody cut the water!
And then they open it, and
sound
I'm
effect?
Like...
Yeah.
They open it, and I'm like, they're all gone.
The turtles are just like... Oh, the callback!
Shit.
Another video.
Is he a stand-up comedian or?
I didn't even know he did stand-up.
Yeah, I thought he was.
His dad died in 9/11. That's where a lot of
his material came from.
Yeah, I didn't know he was doing stand-up again. Yeah, his dad was one of the first responders.
Yeah,
and he had some like kind of.
It's a firefighter. Yeah.
Yeah, he had some material about it.
Yeah.
So that's how he came up like super young as a comic. Like he was funny at like 18, 19.
Yeah, he was on SNL too. He is on SNL. Right?
Yeah. But most stand-ups aren't funny that early.
Because there's no pain.
There's no pain.
You need the pain.
Experience. Yeah. Stand-up takes a lot of Andrew Schultz, who another comedian, he said stand-up is like it's micro skills. You have to have public speaking, timing, setup, audience control, stage presence, like, and that's hard to get early. He's got to get up there and bomb a lot. Yeah. Apparently, he's like, you're not going to get
him. He came up really early, too.
Yeah,
right?
He's one of the few that was really funny.
But he studied it early, too.
He was like 14 when he started.
Yeah, since like junior high, too.
He was in the comedy clubs.
Dave Chappelle?
Oh, Dave Chappelle.
Yeah, he was on Def Comedy Jam at like 18 or 19, too.
Same thing with Seth Rogen.
Really? He gave up, though.
He wrote super bad when he was like 12 or 13.
Yeah.
And then he kept doing stand-up, and I think he made his first big break at that Montreal, like, big comedy thing at like 16.
Just for laughs.
Just for laughs, yeah. Like he was like 16 years old.
And when he could make Superbad, he was too old to play the characters.
Yeah.
Him and Evan.
So that's why he ended up being the cop.
Yeah.
Seth Rogen.
Pete Davidson.
Joe Rogan. I was like,
what? She said it the whole time like, what does he have to do with podcasts?
Joe Rogan did do
He's funny.
Stand-up.
Yeah. No, Seth Rogen.
Yeah.
I heard Pete Davidson got a huge cock.
Really?
Supposedly.
Yeah, big dick energy.
Oh, that's what it is. Big dick energy.
Yeah.
So he's got a medium-sized dick, we don't know?
I don't know. He probably does. Oh, no, I think Ariana Grande did say he has a big dick.
He's a huge cock.
Confirmed?
Yeah, I think she did.
Can we Google it?
Nah.
She also wrote a little barbecue, though.
Why? You don't want to be the only one?
What is it?
You don't want to be the only one?
No, I'm not the guy.
You gotta have a big market.
Don't you brand me. Don't you brand me, Tiff. I brand people, you don't brand people.
I mean, you just look so eager like to, you know, try to get him to join the team.
No. I'm not on the team.
Okay, so lawyers are commenting on this and saying, like, there's no way he can enforce this. Like,
absolutely.
Really. And then just to even take one fan to court for the breach of this NDA, he has to prove that it was $1 million worth of damage.
That's nearly impossible.
Yeah.
It's funny when people fucking are so full of themselves and they have to protect the shit of their craft. It's like, shut the fuck up.
The thing that sucks about stand-up, though, like, you basically are practicing in front of paying customers.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
That's the one thing that sucks.
That's the culture of it. Is like, you're just doing,
I'm back to go on tour again, and I'm like, man, the first couple months, You're just like, well, here goes.
That's why all my friends that don't understand stand-up, when they go, I went to go see this guy. He wasn't that good. I'm like, that's because that's not his set. Like, you have to understand he's practicing in front of you. So you have to have an open mind. He's trying shit out. Like, until they have the big special, the 1 hour thing, that's what they're really putting out there. Yeah. So I'm like, don't judge any stand-up based off of their 10 minutes or anything like that. They're just
I wish I could do this cell phones in bags.
It's different. Like, the comedy clubs is different from, like, when they have, like, a 1,000-person show at, like, the Staples Center or some shit. Like, or whatever. It's that one, I think, they have their set.
Yes.
But then the comedy club that they do, like, every week, like, if you go to Comedy Store or whatever, you see all these top-notch people, and they're not getting paid. Like, they get paid way fucking more, but they're there to practice.
Working out.
Yeah.
That's like Bart. Like you have competitions where you are in shape and ready. Yeah. But, like, at the beginning of your thing, like, on a random Tuesday, you might have, like, a terrible workout. Like, man, I was
like, if someone goes to the gym and they'll be like, Bart's
weak. That's what stand-up is. But imagine somebody watching you lift on a bad day, like, this guy ain't even strong, man. Bart is trash.
Yeah. You know what bothers me the most, though, when I watch, like, stand-up? Because I've only seen comedy shows a couple times, and anytime that there's a comic on stage and you could tell that they're trying to work through the material, but when they blame the audience, that's when I'm like cringing, because I'm like,
audiences suck sometimes though.
Sure, but like, just fucking own up to the fact that your jokes aren't that funny.
No way! It's you, not me! But I'm gonna tell you the thing that's weird though. Sometimes in the same night, like, it could kill at the 7:30 or 7 o'clock show, and then you perform it the exact same way at the 9:30, and they just look at you. So it's like, I know I said it the same way.
With the same set?
Same set, same flexion.
Maybe the first set or the first crowd were just nicer and more drunk.
Oh, it could be.
Yeah.
Because they just got it from pre-gaming?
If your joke is good, it should kill no matter who's listening.
No. Incorrect. Stand-up audiences suck.
You would quit stand-up in a day with that kind of standard.
Yep.
And also, for your confidence, it's a lot easier to be like, man, crowd was trash. Me, I'm good.
You have to.
Those guys suck.
That's true. That's true.
And you know what sucks about stand-up, too, especially in clubs? People like ordering food and like paying for their bill, like you're literally like pouring your heart out. They're like, I ain't have no chicken strips. What are you, no, take that off. I said, I ain't have no chicken strips. And they're like right in the front of the waitress, like, you, oh, there's chicken strips on the table. Them is his. You're like, man, like, I can't get this joke across right now.
That's a good point.
People are literally, especially when you're the headliner, people are paying, like, as you are doing your, supposed to be the best part of your set, that's when the waitresses and waiters come out.
They don't know how to time it, right?
Yes, so a comedian friend of mine, Roy Wood, he said, put your best jokes at like 30 minutes, and the last 15 just do crowd work. Because nobody's paying attention by that time. They're paying tips, they're finishing their last drink and stuff.
Because they want to get their money all the way.
They want to get their money all together, man. They want to do it before you get done, because then people are like, oh, they're out of there. But you're literally performing. That doesn't happen in other things. You don't see Beyonce up there like performing her heart out. You're like, I ain't have no chicken strips, man. Ain't nobody care about what she's doing. You got two chicken strips on there.
Well, we were all at a stand-up shows with Tiff and my wife, and when the waitress came for, like, some of these guys, it was so bad, man, that when the waitress came, I was like, oh, thank God. Can we just talk for a second?
Yeah, they were pretty bad.
I've been
see,
that
those
bad
guys,
before.
Like, see, that's what I'm talking about.
Yeah, they were just disrespecting the audience.
Yeah, where they're like blaming us because they fucking suck. Where I'm like, nah, dude.
Yeah. That happens all the time. Yeah, it's like open mic shit.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.